I am from Gauras, Mazhab. I shall explain question number 3, para C of exercise 6.2, chapter 6, application of derivative. Now come out to solution here. Solution para C. Here I shall write, given that f of x equal to sin x. Again I shall write imply that f of x equal to sin x. Imply that dwrt x implied that d over dx of f of x equal to d over dx of sin x. Implied that d over dx of f of x comes out to be f dash x equal to d over dx of sin x comes out to be cos x. Here we have got f dash of x equal to cos x. So here we can see that f dash x of cos x, f dash of x equal to cos x greater than 0, greater than 0 in open interval 0, comma pi by 2 open interval, and also f dash x equal to cos x less than 0 in open interval pi by 2 comma pi. F dash of x is equal to cos x greater than 0 in open interval 0 comma pi by 2 open interval. F dash of x equal to cos x less than 0 in open interval pi by 2 comma pi open interval. So here we can see that f dash x is positive and negative in open interval 0 comma pi open interval. Hence f of x is neither increasing nor decreasing in open interval 0 comma pi open interval. Here I have written solution of para C of question number 3, exercise 6.2, chapter 6, application of derivative, NCERT 12 mathematics. Given that f of x equal to sin x. Given that f of x equal to sin x. Here I have written implied that f of x equal to sin x. dwrt x. Implied that d over dx of f half x equal to d over dx of sine x imply that d over dx of f half x comes out to be f dash of x equal to d over dx of sine x comes out to be cos x. So here you can see here in para A is strictly increasing in open interval 0 comma pi by 2 open interval. This means that f of x f dash of x equal to cos x is greater than 0 in open interval 0 comma pi by 2 open interval. And f dash of x equal to cos x less than 0 in open interval pi by 2 comma pi open interval. We see that f dash x is positive. Here cos x is greater than 0 in open interval 0 comma pi by 2 open interval. So f dash x is positive and f dash of x is equal to cos x less than 0 in open interval pi by 2 comma pi open interval. So here negative in open interval 0 comma pi open interval. Hence f of x is neither increasing nor decreasing in open interval 0 comma pi open interval. This is the proper explanation and solution of question number 3, para C, exercise 6.2 of chapter 6, application of derivative of NCERT 12 by 12. Okay guys, thanks.